Leigh. She has built a very successful youth cost business, which was recently nominated for the Business of the Year Award by Athlone Chamber of Commerce. Coming from a traditional business background, Elaine has seen firsthand the massive investment and ongoing overhead associated with being in business. So when she was introduced to Juice Plus franchise, she immediately saw that with no investment, no stock, and huge potential, she could develop a business that could offer her family financial freedom. She's a QMD and very, very focused on the next level of NMD. Elaine is going to give us a business perspective on the Juice Plus franchise. Please give your big, massive welcome to Elaine Allen.
Here Friday evening for James Knight. Absolutely fantastic presentation. I love James' take on a professional side of our product, and it's absolutely great to have him over here and great to hear him. So, an absolutely beautiful. Also, thank you very much to each and every one of you for putting me onto the stage. It is an absolute honour to be asked to be up here to present. That's what I was driving up here this morning. I kind of said to myself when Eddie Shops and told me what I was presenting on to give a business perspective on my own business and Juice Plus, I kind of thought, am I qualified to stand up here and give a business perspective? And you know, I had to think for a minute and I have to say, I'm 21 years this year running my own business and catering operation with my sister Leigh in Athlone. And you know, I am a business person, I am a businesswoman, but sometimes you don't always feel like that and you certainly don't get recognised for that in my style of business, in traditional business in Ireland. So you kind of lose that I'm a business person. Because there are many people here today outside of Juice Plus franchise who have no business. Show of hands. Okay, brilliant. So sometimes you just forget, you're so busy running your business, you actually forget that you're a business person. But the last 18 months, I have been recognized more as a business person through this business than I have for the last 21 years. And this slide makes a life, not just a living. And Jenny, you asked me to pick this book up in Arizona, and I read it perfectly first. And that basically summed up why I'm on stage here today. On flight home, I was sitting beside somebody. Mary Pennell was with her kids in front of us, and I was beside somebody. Mary said, you'd probably be sitting beside somebody who's involved in Juice Plus. All you want to talk about is explain to people how you can help their head and talk about your product. You're so passionate about it because you feel so well. But I got to sit beside a lovely couple, and it wasn't talking about just because it was just talking in general. And he turned around to me one day and said, actually, what do you do? And I normally turn around and say, oh, I run a restaurant catering operation, it's great, it's fantastic, which it is. I said, I actually teach people how to make a life, not just a living. He said, sorry? I said, yeah. I'm actually at a clinical conference, and that's what I do. And all of a sudden, we had this massive conversation, and it never went back to Juice Plus. But he was like, wow, that's fantastic. And I basically told him my story. So this morning, I'm not going to spend hours explaining what I've done for the last 21 years, but I want to give you a brief journey of where I've come to today with my traditional business and where I've come with my Juice Plus business. And I'll kind of keep as brief and as light as I can. So, restaurant and catering operation, 21 years this year. We have a 60-seater restaurant in Athlone called Slice of Life, and we also run an outside catering company as well. I suppose with that, with a lot, I suppose what I'm going to be talking about is small size businesses. So, we have a staff of 17. So, anything from 17 down, a lot of people can relate to this. So, to set up my business originally, I set it up with myself and another girl. I set up a very, very small building in Athlone. I was working at that time, I had gone to college and I went home to my parents and I said, I don't want to work for somebody else, I want to work for myself. And my parents said, listen, you have a job, you're getting a wage, you're mad. And I said, no, you know, I'm 3 years working for somebody else, I'd like to set up my own. And my parents both are entrepreneurs in their own right, both of them have had all their life their own businesses. My mother has a B&B and my dad has a carpentry joinery business. So I kind of had a thing, and I said no. And they were like, you know, Elaine, I'm not sure, you can't just walk out of a job. I said, no, I can't. I was like what David Ryan said to me on Saturday night. You know, I made that decision and I said, I am going to do this. I'm going to set up my own business. I felt with the market out there for the qualities I wanted to sell. And all I wanted to do was produce fresh food and be able for people to take it home and enjoy it in their homes. So I set up a delicatessen. And like that, my dad helped me and was, you know, a bit of, oh God, and everybody telling me you're absolutely mad. And the more people that told me I was mad, I said, no, I'm not mad. This is what I want to do for me. And it'll never work. They're over that side of town where absolutely nothing is happening. And I said, this is all I can afford at the time. To set up that business at that time took an awful lot of my time, long hours. And there was a bit of a patch of investment there. But I didn't mind. At that time, I was young, free, and single, and I didn't value my time. And people didn't value it because I didn't value my time. So it didn't matter how many hours I was worked that week. So there was two of us opened on our first day. And I remember Liz Dyke was the girl's name at the time. We sat on two mayonnaise buckets when we opened the door. And I was expecting like hundreds of people to come in and just buy it. And I think that day we took our takings were £60 at the time. I'm like, oh my God, I have to pay you, I have to pay me, I have to pay the bank. £60. And we were laughing, it was real fun. Like, we were sitting on too many of these things. I said, what is this in point? I have got to get a baby, I have to pay people to pay my rent. And like, that was the realization, okay, I'm going to have to do something here. So I had nobody to turn to because I couldn't tell the banks, I couldn't tell my dad, nobody came in to buy much today. So we followed up. I worked day and night because with my catering business, I could build up a little bit of a turnover to pay for the wages and to get everybody sorted for a while. Okay, it took a couple of years to get there. Eventually got there. My sister saw it all going on and decided, this is great, but I'm going to come home and join. I said, great. She actually came home only because she fell in love with a lovely guy and she wanted to come back. Nothing to do but wanting to join me for the business. And I'd be might turn into work at 10 o'clock, and I there at 7 o'clock that morning. I was opening, I was closing. I was the plumber, the electrician, the carpenter. I was everybody. But it didn't matter. This business was going to work. And it was beginning to work. And I was getting my turnover up. I was paying my bills. 8 or 9 years down the road, we're getting on wage. We had increased our staff. We had built a kitchen, or moved to a, we had a kitchen and another facility. But we were getting so busy that we needed to reinvest. And everybody was saying, we've done so well now. And it's a little like when you start up the first 6 months, you're mad, here for 6 months, you'll be gone. 6 months down the road, still there, it must be all right, maybe we should win and support it. A year down the road in business, everybody wants to come to you because they think you're brilliant. So I said, okay, it's time to have a look at this. So I suddenly looked at it, and 8 years ago, we made a massive jump, massive capital investment, and moved to our 60-seater restaurant in Bond Street. And that's when things got really, really serious. Because then we went from 5 staff to 17, and we went to serious repayments, big capital investments, a lot of financial pressure. Both of us were married at that time with young kids. So rather than, I thought it would get easier if I had more staff, because I had somebody who would open and somebody who would close, and I just fit the bits in the middle, it was going to get harder. Because I now opened my doors every day at a loss. I had to get a turnover to pay my staff, my overheads, that never changed. We cannot open our doors without a minimum of 6 staff a day, regardless of if one come in the door or 50 come in the door. So that's our business. It's very, very labor intensive. It's where we're at. Staff commitments, our support very, very lucky. A lot of our staff are with us many number of years and you don't have high staff turnover. But if somebody rings in sick, or if somebody decides to leave or go on maternity, we should replace them. So if you're looking to retrain staff, keep your staff on, and my staff are my sharp point. So if you come into the door tomorrow and somebody's not feeling great and she's very sharp there, or she doesn't serve you really in a nice manner, you're not going to come back. But it hasn't been my problem, even though she's my number of staff. So there's a lot of headaches in staff. Plus, every week of the year, we have a staff member on holidays. That's double time, double pay. We have to pay every single week of the year. Turnover pressure, I've already touched on turnover pressure. We have a certain turnover we have to meet every single week or we're at a loss in the bank. That's a fact. That's reality. It's reality for a lot of companies. Holidays for the boss. Now, I'm only back from holidays. But the reason is because I have a sister who can cover me for when I'm gone. So when I originally started, I didn't have a holiday for the first 4 or 5 years. I was talking to a buddy of mine only the other day who's in retail. She works for herself, she has her own business. And she can't take a holiday because she doesn't have anybody to cover. Nobody knows her business. So she has to be there, and it's beginning to get to her. It was great for the first few years. Now it's like, I want to go on holidays, but I can't leave the place unless I close it, and I can't afford to close it for 2 weeks. So I've been lucky, I have a backup. But a lot of people in business don't have backups, and you'll notice that. And when we were on holidays, both myself and Erwin did say, there's very few people over here that own their own business, because neither have the money nor the time to be here on holidays. So I have been lucky, and I'll show you the reason why I've been lucky shortly. So everybody, every member of my staff works 37 and a half hours a week. They all get their bank holidays, and they all get their 21 days and 12 months every single year. Does the boss get that? Absolutely no. I get one holiday a year. Well, I used to. 2 weeks. Take it or leave it. That's it. You work every bank holiday. That's just the way it is. That's what a boss has to do. And lack of freedom. I suppose this is where I was 18 months ago. I was getting frustrated. I had 2 young kids. I couldn't be at their swimming. I couldn't be at their stuff on Saturday because I was stuck in work. I had to run up to work every single day. Be it at 7 o'clock in the morning to 6 in the evening. It didn't matter if there was something on. I had to be there. That's just the way our business is structured. We're a very people business in our restaurant. We have a lot of the people business. People expect you to be there. And reinvestment. As I spoke to you, 8 years ago, we made a massive investment. So all of this happens after the first 8 to 10 years of business, when you start to make money, when you pay to the banks and everything's great. Your equipment starts to get depleted, your restaurant needs to be repainted, you need to reinvest. So you're getting on with, and all of a sudden, I can't stay here, times are moving on, I have to move with the times, I need to reinvest. So you go back to the banks again, you become a workaholic, and the cycle continues. I don't know if a lot of people can relate to that. I'd say a lot of people can, but that's where we were at, or where sometimes what traditional business can bring to you. Yes, it's very, very positive, and it's fantastic, and I love what I do. And as Jamie Brennan said to me before I came up on the stage, he said, "You're nervous." I said, "Of course I'm nervous. Like, this is not my normal Sunday." He said, "You're normally at home making fun." And I said, "Yes, I normally am. All of this is easy in the kitchen." But it's not as fast as rewarding as this. So absolutely, I love my job, but the background stuff is tough to take. What I saw in the Juice Plus franchise, and I say this a lot, January 2015, the 10th January 2015, I sat in the room here as well. And I was in the business a couple of months, not taking it very, very serious. All I wanted was to share a fantastic product with people that need it, because it had given me so much energy. It had given me back my drive in life. I was able to work longer hours. So I thought, everybody needs this. We all live busy lifestyles. But what I saw was that if I took this business serious, the one thing I didn't have was time. But I could do this Juice Plus franchise part-time in my time, and it suited me. It was completely flexible. So that was really, really important to me. Freedom, the choice of who I could work with and where I could work. So I didn't have to go into work every morning at 9 o'clock and stay there at 10 o'clock or 6 o'clock in the evening. I had a choice. I had the freedom to choose with whom I worked with and where, because this business is in over 26 countries. So that was a massive one for me as well. Financial. Uncapped earnings. Who would want that? An opportunity to earn what I wanted. If I was happy earning 200 euros a month, brilliant. But I wanted more. And to know that that opportunity was there for each and every person, because we all start at the same level. It's up to you to where you want to go. I start every day my Juice Plus franchise with a profit. I am never in negative equity, and I love that word, because it's a 6 euro investment. I've already covered my cost because I'm already my own product. So every day I open my office with a profit. There is no business I know that can open their office every morning working with a profit. Opportunity. I've had massive opportunities in the last year, and I'll go to the really near the end. One was travel. I've been born and bred in Leigh and Athlone. I wouldn't leave the nest. I went to college in Athlone because I wanted to save my parents money. I went to Leigh for 2 years to work. I came back to Athlone and set up my business. So the furthest I've ever been is Athlone, and maybe most. The most I've ever got from any supplier or any company that I've been dealing with over the last 21 years is an invitation to broadcast that I have to pay for myself. I've never been brought here. This company have recognized me more than I can count on my hands. They have given me massive travel opportunities. I've been to London, Birmingham, Arizona. Places I would never, I've been afraid to go on my own. Actually, I think that's the family afraid I was going because I think I'd get there. But that was absolutely massive, and I suppose I didn't see that. And it's like the opportunity to present your business or whatever you're asked to do with this company. Never turn down an opportunity, because one opportunity leads you to the next. And everybody's afforded opportunities in this business. It's for everybody, which is absolutely massive. I get to meet top entrepreneurs. My idol is Dave O'Brien. I met him when I was on the product. I was training for the marathon. I just totally got his vibe. All I wanted was for Dave to come to us home. I met a top entrepreneur, nobody probably knows his name, Eddie Shopsy, somewhere down there. He heads me an odd day when he replies to my text messages. People like that who've been in business, who started at the bottom and built strong, solid businesses, were there to help me, were there to give me support. Donald Brennan this morning, my language, there was an issue with the lifter and a few things, and I'm not technical, and I was like, okay, right. And Donald was like, we'll get it sorted. Donald was sorting that for me. I didn't have to worry about it. I just walked in this morning and said, Donald, Elaine, you're ready to go, don't worry about it. Because these people are here to help and support you. They've done it before, they're doing it every day. That's what it's about, the help and support. So that was absolutely massive, because when I was in bothering her, I had nobody to ask. I had nobody to ask for help, nobody to give me help. The other really, really important part of this business was the team. And I have to say, there's over 25 of my team here over at the weekend, from Saturday and today. And they inspire me every single day. I, being a boss, you're not the nice person at work, because you have to make the hard decisions. You have to tell the people to, you know, you didn't do that correctly. You have to be on time. You have to motivate 12 or 13 people every single day. So you're not always the nice person. You call the shots. But I saw this business that I was going to have an opportunity to work with people, that people weren't going to be working for me anymore, that we were all going to work together. People will do what you do, not what you tell them to do. That's what I heard from this business, and that's what I wanted. I wanted friends. I wanted to have people to share a brilliant opportunity with, to have some fun with. And I wanted to be able to help them to build a business. I cannot help my washed-up person to move up the ladders, because I need her on washing. That's where I need her to stay. She's good on washing. She does a super job, very, very important job actually in my business. That job is done correctly. But I don't want her to move up the ranks. I want her to stay there. I was given the opportunity to help other people build the businesses that they want for themselves. And that really, really attracted me to this business. Personal development. Stepping outside your comfort zone. Never heard it before in my life. Didn't know what people were talking about. On your ass to step outside your comfort zone. And I can tell you, when you're under Eddie O'Shaughnessy, there are an hour's notice for you to go off and do something. And then it's fine. Okay, I just do what? But you know what? They're stepping stones. The personal development along the Juice Plus franchise, I really didn't get it at the beginning, but through the Jim Rohn books, through various stuff that I've been asked to have a look at, there's a massive personal development, and you grow as a person. You grow as you go along. And it has an absolute massive. And it's not easy to stand up here for anybody on the stage, be it being hosting or presenting. But because you're going with your business, it just comes naturally, because you're talking about something that you feel very, very passionate about. So there's a massive personal development. And that helps you to every aspect of life, to your own personal life, your own business life, whatever the case may be. So, the most important part is, how was I going to earn through God? Okay, this is fine, it all looks great on the outside. Like, I need to get Mrs. Brittany's here. How do I earn an income to build the lifestyle I would like to have? It's people business. Absolutely. And if you love people, you'll absolutely love this business. You share the product and business with others and help them do the same. That's as hard as it gets. You build relationships with customers. I remember when I first opened up my restaurant tomorrow. I was thinking that it's a bit of a bump. How am I going to get turnover in here? I went to a couple of motivational people, a couple of people in business to get their advice. And one advice I've always stuck with over 20 years ago was that this guy stood up one day and said, if you turn your customers into friends, they'll never leave you. Don't just treat customers as a number. Build a relationship with your customers. Get to know their first name terms, get to know their friends, and before something goes wrong, before they leave you, they will tell you. So when something is going wrong in my restaurant, 90% of my customers are our friends, we know them by first name terms. They'll tell us that they're not happy with that apple pie, and it was not good today, then. But that's better for that person to tell me than go out to the whole world and tell 10 or 20 people not to go into the slice of the apple pie isn't good. It could be the last cup of tea that you make might have been just perfect, but to get a call at 10 o'clock at night for a customer to give out about something, it's far better. But if they aren't my friend, if they don't respect me as a person, if they don't think I care about them, they're not going to bother, they're just going to walk out. That's really, really important. Make friends, build a team, working with like-minded people, absolutely. This business is full of positive people. We're all very, very much like-minded. We have an entrepreneurial spirit about us. That's what I see, and that's what you get to build. Listen, learn, teach. This is really, really important. It's really important to listen, and sometimes we're great listeners, but we don't learn. We go off and do it our own way. And say, ah, he has a clue, sure, he's every 70 odd. What do you know about it? But he actually does know. He knows an awful lot more about it than me. But you learn from your mentors. You get to get caught by the best, but listen, but you've got to learn, okay? And then you can teach somebody what you've learned. So those three words, listen, learn, and teach, are really, really important. Because if you can't learn, you can't teach. And if you can't teach, you can't build a team. I was asked in a phone call by Donald McCarthy, who was trying to get involved in this business that I was telling him I was having absolutely nothing to do with. How ambitious are you? And I'm like, sorry? I don't even know you. How ambitious are you? I said, I've never really been asked that question. What do you say on a scale of, like, 1 to 10, how ambitious are you? But I said, I think I'm really ambitious. It's like this, if I was running a race in the morning and you were beside me and both of the train together, I'd get the end line before you, definitely. That's fine. I mean, I love you.
We all agree to that.
So yeah, I give it that to me at our time. But how ambitious are you? Okay, I think all inside of you have great ambition. You know, and don't be afraid of it, because I think a lot of us limit our ambition to fear. I know Laura McClory has often said this, our fear. Don't be afraid of your ambition. Because sometimes when we're kids, we have no fear of a great ambition. But as you get older in life, you're told you're not allowed to dream. You're not allowed to have that want. You know, calm down a little. You know, that's not the norm. Be ambitious. The higher your ambition, the more you learn, the longer you stay, guys. Do not quit in this business. Never quit. The more you care, the bigger your income. And absolutely, without a shadow of a doubt. If you can curve those four things. I told you this morning, she's going to absolutely kill me now, and I picked up my babysitter. And she's now in college, she does work part time. An absolutely lovely girl. She plays county football as well. And she's been injured. But anyway, she went on to use plus. And I was not sure about the business because I knew she's a very ambitious girl. No, I haven't time. Now she's a student. And she made herself afford to use plus because she knew it was good for her. And she trusted me, I think, a little bit. But jumping on, she took out the business. But this morning, she's been at a wedding, a family wedding, all weekend. And she said to me, I'll be there some more. And I said, great. And I said, all right. I said, I'll be there 10 days. No problem, that's fine, I just can't try because I've been out for a few drinks last night. But Lorna cares. She was talking to me as a young girl about the people she's spoken to, how she's spoken to them, about her caring attitude towards them. And that's why she's going to be really, really successful in this business, because she cares, she's ambitious, she's learning all the way, and I'm learning from her, and I will not let her quit. Get tested get here because I'm sure I need somebody telling me I'm nearly out of time. If you want to build a big building, a big business, you've got to have a big congregation. That's common sense. So if you don't want to build a big business, you can keep your congregation small. But if you want to go big, let's have a look. Okay, so if I introduce two people to this business, show them how to introduce two more, so on and so forth. Five down, I've got 62 people in my organization. Okay, nice and simple, nice hand to be generated, nice people to make them there. What if I add one more person to that equation? So I introduce three friends. I think all of us here might have three friends to the business. I show them how to introduce three more, and down we jump along. I have over 300 people now in my organization by just introducing one extra person. I'm not going out here getting 100 customers. I'm building a small customer base, and I'm teaching others how to do the same. And that's what got me, because every day when I go to work, I have to constantly build my customers. I need a large amount of customers to come into my restaurant every single day. I need to know their name, I need to be in contact with them, I need to make sure they're getting on really, really well. That's a lot of time. So I thought, if I sell 100, 200 customers, I'm not going to have time to grab all those. No, I build a small customer base, and I teach people how to do the same. So by introducing an extra person, I've increased my team by over 300 people. How about five? This is where the power of numbers lies. This is what you need to be looking at here. This is what this business is about. This is why it's easy. This is why it's successful. Five people, 25. They bring five onto their team. All of a sudden, I'm 3,905 people in my organization. There's a big difference there. Over 3,000. The power of numbers. The law of averages. Who do you know that wants to look better, feel good, and live longer?
Everybody.
Equate that with your numbers. Absolutely possible. Absolutely. Everybody should be driving for five and beyond. Because everybody can. It's not who you know. It's who they know. And I have been introduced to people that I haven't known, but friends of mine haven't known. Because I've asked. And if you don't ask, you won't receive. So don't be afraid to ask. Don't be afraid to ask anybody who loves Juice Plus, doesn't want to take out a business. Do you know anybody who'd be interested in having a look at this business model? Be proud, guys. You need to share it. The business of the future. Absolutely. People are so busy that they forget about building a future. Life becomes about paying bills. Anybody here feel like that? We've rocked all the product the last few days. Totally concrete, everything about that. We have a product everybody needs. Everybody needs good health now more than ever. The stage, the crisis of people's health at the moment, of our children's health. James touched on it earlier. So everybody needs our product. They'll never know if we don't tell them. Choose your avenue. Okay, it's your pace, you set it. People will do what you do, not what you tell them to do. So it's up to you to decide what you want this business. It's up to me and each and every person here. Would you choose your pace, how fast you want to go and where you want to go? Start to think about your future. Really, really important. Step away from the crowd. Okay, I don't watch Coronation Street every single Monday or Wednesday night, whatever it was. I'm not sitting at home looking at an X Factor. No, I'm busy. I'm busy building my business because my kids are in bed. You're stepping away from the crowd. You're not acting like the norm. I'm not at home today doing things. I'm stepping away from you. You're stepping away from the crowd. You're making a stand for yourself. Really, really important. But it's nice being there because you're different and you have something different to offer. And this is really, really important. Find your why. So guys, my why is huge and it does move me to emotion. And it's because of where I've come from, and it's because of where I know I can go. You've got to trust the process and live it out loud. And I tell myself every single day why I'm doing this and where I'm going with it. Because I love hearing it. People want their life to be different, but they cannot believe it can. And that is the truth. People cannot believe that you can create a better life or a different life. they're afraid. And they can't believe, they can't believe you can do it either. People have forgotten how to dream, and that's absolutely true. We're just so consumed with life, with busyness. You know, is there a future out there? It's just like one girl said to me the other day, oh, you know, I'm on my own business here to grow from my parents. Like, you just work day and night, that's what you do. No, it's not what you do. It's what people expect you to do. And why should you do it? Why should you give your life to a job 24/7 that's going to be continually 24/7? What are you going to get out of it? You know, there's no point in not going out and enjoying your life. Like, I was always the one that had to work every bank holiday. And if you're going to a wedding, you're running at 6 o'clock in the evening because you have to work that day. Oh, I'm here. And you'd be first home that night because you'd be back in the next morning, right and breathing with everybody. You know, that was a given. You never got your bank holiday weekend. You know, that was the way it was. Until you decided you wanted to change it, but you didn't know how you were going to. And then you landed here a year ago. And the last 8-9 months, I'm just going to give you a brief synopsis of where it's broadening. I was sent to school, Queen MG School, a really good friend of mine, Lauren McClory, that I did not know last June, and both of us were sent over. It was a fantastic experience. I met Laura at the airport. Hi. That was it. We came home, we were inseparable. And that was, I suppose, a testament to two Irish girls that landed in the middle of the UK, and we just did not know. Both of us said to us, like, what are we going to? I haven't a clue. And we spent a weekend with the company, expensive take again, to learn about how we could build our businesses and the different structures involved. That was absolutely, really fantastic time. My first time ever in London. Dave O'Brien, I mean, I keep coming back to this guy. I mean, I remember saying it to Joan and Eddie, like, I love Dave from Athlone, not a whole thing. I really love him. Like, if we've got nothing out of this business, just let Dave come to Athlone, will you? Eddie was scratching his head, and then he rings me, I think about 2 weeks before, yeah, you have him on April 26th. And I said, what? Yeah, he's coming up, you better have 100 people in the room. I'm like, no problem. And we did, so that room 100 more people. Absolutely delighted. Fantastic event, and Dave was buzzing on the stage. It was just brilliant. I was running out of time with a lot of athletes, and I, you know, there's always one more step in life. And that, I thought that was the best thing ever. The team of people that I've got to grow and love, oh my God, they shake me sometimes with their enthusiasm, their passion, their belief, what they do, and what I want them to do, and where I want them to be, has just been fantastic. And we have great fun times. Sometimes, you know, you feel, oh God, will we ever get out for a night? But I know last night there was a super night out there. Just fantastic. And that's so important. Work is important. But enjoying yourself is equally important. And it's being able to enjoy yourself with the people that you work for every single day. I talk to team members every single day. I think I'd be lost without them. We're in constant contact. It's not a WhatsApp, it's Facebook, whatever the case may be. Because we care about one another. And I know they're here to support me today. You know, and that's been absolutely fantastic. We could have went home and got on with the household stuff that we all have, but we didn't. And I really, really appreciate it, guys. Thank you very much. The conference in Birmingham, and I was asked to represent the Rising Stars in the panel over there. Wow, that was just fantastic. And we were backstage, and I served you, please come with me, I'm not going back there on my own. And it was a group that went over, and it was just fantastic. It was a great atmosphere, it was great to be part of it. I was the only Irish girl on that panel. Laura McClory opened up the conference on Saturday, 5 months. Absolutely great. So that was a massive experience for me. And really good. I got to meet Jay Martin in Arizona. I was asked to go over as part of the test pilot project for the Tower Gardens in March. And I met Jay Martin and just had a wonderful conversation with him. And so that's the founder of our company. Just, hi, hey, how are you? General chit chat. Fantastic. Got to meet millionaire John Holabotti. Another, how are you, Leigh? How's it going? Fantastic! And I'm happy! These people are just ordinary, down-to-earth people that are just there to help and support you. And they have just got on with their business. They're nothing else than just kept their head down and built their businesses. We got to represent, and this is very, very close to my heart, we got to represent I Was and What It Is. So Leigh had to go and pick up our award. We were nominated for Enterprise of the Year Award for our Juice Plus franchise. We put the restaurant and our Juice Plus application in. Our restaurant is 21 years, it's very successful in town. And our Juice Plus franchise got nominated and we became third finalist, which was absolutely fantastic. When you're coming from business in a local town, and you all these business people are wondering, what are you doing? What are you asking about? The Chamber of Commerce has been absolutely massively supportive of us and absolutely love this business model, so it was great to get recognised, and it was a great representation of that being here that night as well. But last, but certainly not above least, or least I should say, the most important thing in my life that I wanted was to be able to give quality time to the most important people in my life, which are my family. And for somebody like me, I'm not very young, and I can't go out there in the morning and get into a degree and maybe take another channel in the life, like kind of give myself back a little bit more time and afford myself another opportunity. But this business has given me the opportunity to earn part-time income that matches my full-time income at the moment for my restaurant business, and an opportunity to further increase that. And the people who are going to benefit most from that, because I'm going to take, and I do take a step back now from my full-time business, because I can afford to pay somebody else to be there, and I don't have to work Sundays anymore, and I don't have to work nights anymore, which has been fantastic. And the people that would benefit this are my two sons, Matthew and Evan Allen. And this day, they're two good dudes, yeah. But anyhow, this day, I got to change my car last year. I went to prospect the BMW dealer in Athlone because I actually knew he needed Juice Plus, he was wrecked. And I ended up coming out of the car and he ended up going on Juice Plus. But you know what? Urban said, fair trade. And he was, what? Yeah, I changed the car. Because you're absolutely mad, you can't afford this. I said, yes, you can. That's my office. I have time in the morning when I go to work, time to leave when I come home. I need Bluetooth. And the car is my office. I promised the Earth I would pay for the car. A big going. But the two dudes were absolutely thrilled in bed being like 5 and 7. So anyhow, that's the car queue up there and the two dudes. We've been able to give them a really, really great time. And as I said, our holiday that we're just back from, 2 weeks spent in Lanzarote, in a fantastic place. And I couldn't have done that on my present job, quite honest. I couldn't have the last 8 or 9 months that I have had, except for this business, and that's what it can do. It just brings an ordinary life into a very, very extraordinary life that is an awful lot of fun. My last and closing words: success is not final, failure is not fatal or fatal. It is the courage to continue that counts, and that's what I leave you with. Please have the courage to take this business on, to continue, and to build it to where you want it to go, because to me, it is absolutely a breath of fresh air.